Hello students, in the previous class we have studied about climate and adaptation of organisms according to the climate. Now today we shall study about one more adaptation acquired by the birds which helps them to move from one place to another. Now this is again the adaptation features of the birds according to the climate. So there are certain birds which migrate from one place to another in the extreme climate due to the extreme climatic conditions. Such birds are called as the migratory birds. So what is migration? Migration is a seasonal journey taken by the different animals or the birds to escape the extreme climatic condition and the search of food. So why these animals or the birds, they travel from one place to another? Because of the extreme climatic condition, and the second reason is in the search of food. Example, Siberian cranes. As you can see the diagram here, Siberian cranes, they migrate towards the warmer region in the autumn by traveling several thousands of kilometers. Now these Siberian cranes, they cannot live or survive in the extreme cold climate. So what they do? So when they are living in one part of the world where it is extreme cold, they migrate towards the warmer region. So they are seen in the Bharatpur, Rajasthan, Bharatpur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana, and sometime in wetland of northeast and other parts of India. So we don't find such birds throughout the year in our country, but we can see these birds in the few in the summer, especially in during the summers in our country. So why we can see them is because of the migration. So migratory birds sometimes travel as much as 15,000 kilometers to escape the extreme climatic condition of their habitat. These birds fly high where the wind flow is helpful and cold conditions allow them to disperse the heat generated by their flight muscles. Now you must be thinking these birds do not have any map. So how they can fly, because the sky appears a same, like same for us from all the direction. So what helps these birds to fly? So it is the wind which is blowing. So these birds fly high where the wind is flowing, which is very helpful for them, and also the cold conditions allow them to disperse the heat generated by their flight muscles. Now these birds have a built-in sense of direction and know in which direction they have to travel. So with the sense of in which direction they have to travel, with the help of wind, they are able to cover the distance. Some birds use landmarks to guide them. Now they also have certain landmarks, because they remember last time we traveled from this way, what is the route? So they also have this landmarks. Some birds are guided by the sun during the daytime and by the stars during the night. Some birds can use the magnetic field of the earth to find the direction. See, when we talk about the human being as the supreme power, even these birds, which as compared to human beings are not so powerful, but they are being gifted with such kinds of powers where they can sense, right? So they see, they can sense the wind, they can sense the sun direction by the stars, also the magnetic field of the earth. They do not have any radar or compass with them. They can still sense the magnetic field of the earth to find the direction. Besides, birds, some fishes, insects and mammals also migrate seasonally in search of more hospitable conditions. It's not only that birds will always do the migration. Many times it is fishes, insects and mammals also which migrate seasonally. Okay, so just now we have seen about the migratory birds. Now we shall watch a video on the migration of the birds.
In America, migration is a way of life. These are the roots of some 3 billion birds that stream north every spring. Flying thousands of miles to every corner of the continent. To find food. To find a mate. To raise a family. Off the west coast.
So, we just now see how the migration of the birds takes place. Now, this was all about the polar region, extreme cold climate. Now, we are going to see the next part, that is a tropical region of the Earth. Now, the Earth is divided into many parts, in the many regions. So, one of the region is a tropical region. Now, when we look at the structure of the Earth has been divided into different zones. We can see here, this is a central one that is called as equator, which is at zero latitude. Okay, then we have Tropic of Cancer, which is 23 degree north. And then below, in the south, we have Tropic of Capricorn, 23 degree south. So, this layer from equator to Tropic of Cancer are called as tropical zone. From equator to Tropic of Capricorn, it is called as a tropical zone. So, in both in north direction, in upwards and downwards of the equator, we have this tropical zone, which you can see is written with the red color. Now, above Tropic of Cancer, towards the Arctic Circle, that is a polar region, we have in between the temperate zone. From Tropic of Capricorn to Antarctic Circle, we have temperate zone. And this North Pole and South Pole, we have Arctic zones. Okay, if you can see the measurements, latitudes. So, what is tropical zone? Now, this tropical region lies near both the sides of equator line on the Earth. As you can see here, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, and this whole region in between from equator to tropic, this is called as the tropical zones. Again, we have subtropical zone also present here. Okay, so what are these regions? These regions are very hot, but get plenty of rainfall. Therefore, this region is humid. When we talk about the temperature or the climate at these places, it is hot, rainfall is there, plenty of rainfall. Therefore, the region is said to be humid. Even in the coldest month, the temperature is generally higher than about 15 degrees Celsius. So, even if you have the extreme cold climate, still the temperature will be above 15 degrees Celsius. So, you can imagine about the summers then. So, during the hot summers, the temperature may cross 40 degrees Celsius. Days and nights are almost equal in length throughout the year because it is very hot. So, the tropical, so very important feature of the tropical region is a tropical rainforest. So, tropical rainforest is the important feature of tropical region. These regions are rich in vegetation and large diversity in it is also seen in this region of animals. So, here you find a large number of variations in the flora and fauna. Okay, maximum flora and fauna you will find in the tropical region. Now, in India, this tropical rainforest are found in Western Ghats. These are your Western Ghats and Assam, which have the tropical rainforest. Now, here in the map of India, you can see even the colors which we can see here, they are different tropical regions. Now, the dark green, which you can see, they are the tropical evergreen forest. So, it means here, the Kerala, half part of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, you can see, it is covering the tropical evergreen forest. Then you have this fluorescent green color, tropical moist deciduous forest. So, you can see entire of the east part of the country. Then you can see the West Bengal, Orissa, all Jharkhand, all are comprising. Then few parts of Uttar Pradesh, Uttaranchal, then Punjab, right? So, these are what your tropical moist deciduous regions. Then tropical dry deciduous, and then yellow color you can see tropical thorn. It means desert area where you will not find this tropical rainforest. So, this is how our country is divided into various kinds of tropical regions. So, we are very lucky that in our country we have this tropical region where we have hot, cold and humid climate. All the three are there. When we talk about the world, the tropical rainforest, the other countries of the world like Southeast Asia. We can see here Southeast Asia, the red color ones are shown with the tropical rainforest. So, all these parts of the world, they are covered with the tropical rainforest. As I was telling you, this black color line which you can see is the equator. And here up above, you have Tropic of Cancer. As you can see, India is here and this Tropic of Cancer is passing through India through Gujarat. Right? That's why that area, Gujarat and half part of Maharashtra, it comes under very Tropic of Cancer. So, that is why we receive the climate here is very hot. Now the below part, Tropic of Capricorn. So this is the region of the tropical region. Okay, you find maximum number of flora and fauna flourishing here. So diversity of flora and fauna can be seen in the tropical region. So the country is Southeast Asia, Central America, Malaysia, Indonesia, Brazil, Republic of Congo, Kenya, Uganda, Nigeria, Central Africa, and also are also having this tropical rainforest. So it means all the climate here will be hot and humid. That's why African countries are said to be very, very warm, very hot. Brazil, again a very hot country. Malaysia, Indonesia. Okay. So the major type of animals living in the rainforest are monkeys, apes, gorillas, tigers, elephants, leopards, lizards, snakes, birds, and insects. Since there are large number of animals found in this region, there is an intense competition for food and shelter among these animals. So as there are number of animals, so there definitely there will be a competition for the food and shelter between these animals. So these animals are adapted in such a way that they eat different kinds of food. So if all of them are fighting for the food, so what is the distribution of the nature is, their body is designed or they have adapted themselves in such a way that they can eat different kinds of food. So all of them are not eating the same type of food. That's why we have different types of food chain and food webs in the ecosystem. And they eat different kinds of food and live in different kinds of places to overcome the competition for food and shelter respectively. That's why the nature has flourished all the animals on this universe and have provided them with the different kinds of food and shelter. So there is no competition for the food, and there is a competition. That's why there is a survival of the fittest. Correct? So there is a competition, but all of them are not eating the same type of food and living in the same type of places. So to overcome is they have been given different kinds of eating habits. Therefore, the body structure of all the animals is different. The place they live, their body structure, everything is different from each other. Now, the adaptation in different animals living in tropical rainforests can be discussed as follows in the next sessions. Now, few of the animals which we are going to study in our further sessions are animals living in the tropical region like red-eyed frog, monkey, lion and tiger, toucan bird, lion tail macaw, and then elephant. Okay, so this all these animals we are going to study in the next session of ours, that is tropical rainforest animals. So here we finish with the tropical region and the migratory birds. I hope all of you have understood it. Let's wait for the next sessions. Stay safe and study.